What are nutrients and why are they stormwater pollutants? Have you heard about the need to reduce nutrient pollution in waterways? Let's find out what these nutrients are and why they are so bad for our water. Nutrients are chemical compounds that are used for growth and maintaining life. All living things, including plants, have specific nutrient needs to grow and thrive. Soil provides nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. These are referred to as primary macronutrients because they are needed in larger quantities for plant growth. Other nutrients, such as calcium, magnesium, sulfur, and zinc, are needed in smaller quantities and are usually referred to as secondary macronutrients or micronutrients. Most nutrients will be in the soil naturally from minerals found in the soil particles, weathering rock, or decaying plants. If there are not enough nutrients existing in the soil to meet plant growth goals, we can add nutrients with materials like synthetic fertilizers, manure, or compost. Plants need to have nutrients available to them throughout their life. Luckily, healthy soils can hold on to some nutrients so that plants can use them throughout the growing season. Soil particles are negatively charged, and many nutrients are positively charged, so they stick together like magnets. And then nutrients are taken up by plant roots when needed. However, nutrients can move off-site and end up in water bodies in two major ways: runoff and erosion. If we apply too many nutrients, the soil will not be able to hold on to all of them. The extra nutrients can be dissolved in water and carried away in surface runoff. Erosion is the other major way that nutrients can be lost. Erosion is the process of wearing away and moving soil by natural forces, like when there's a heavy rainfall and water runs off and washes away the soil surface, creating muddy-looking water. This is especially the case for bare soil. When soils are allowed to erode, they will carry absorbed nutrients and deposit them into our waterways, resulting in both sediment and nutrient pollution. According to the Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection, erosion and sedimentation is the primary way that nutrients end up in our waterways. Once nutrients get into our streams, rivers, lakes, and ponds, they begin to cause problems. An overabundance of nutrients, typically nitrogen or phosphorus, can result in excessive plant and algae growth, leading to a depletion of oxygen in the water. This process is called eutrophication. Nitrogen is the most limiting nutrient in marine ecosystems, but phosphorus is the most limiting nutrient in our freshwater systems. If even a little extra phosphorus gets into our water bodies, more plants grow rapidly because they have everything else that they need. Algae blooms, meaning that it grows quickly, shading out plants below. Then, as plants and algae die and decay, the dissolved oxygen in the water is depleted, which can create dead zones that may eventually lead to fish kills. Another potential effect of eutrophication is harmful algae blooms, or HABs, which occur when specific types of blue-green algae bloom. Here's a harmful algae bloom in Lake Erie in 2017. HABs can produce toxins that threaten the health of humans and animals and foul drinking water systems. So what can we do to prevent nutrient pollution in our waterways? Before you buy and apply fertilizer, manure, or compost, perform a soil test to find out which nutrients are needed. Then, only apply the nutrients recommended by the soil test. Extra fertilizer is not only a pollution problem, but also a waste of money. Excess fertilizer won't be used by plants and can be washed away by runoff. Make sure you are applying the correct amount of an amendment. Read the labels on synthetic fertilizers and apply at the rate recommended by the soil test. Always sweep fertilizer off hard surfaces back into the lawn or garden. If you're using manure or compost as an amendment, have it tested by the lab so that you know the nutrient content and can apply it based on the soil test recommendation. Keep soil protected from erosion with a cover of vegetation or mulch. In settings with steeper slopes, additional erosion controls may be needed, such as an erosion control blanket. Finally, reducing stormwater runoff in our communities by decreasing impervious surfaces and improving infiltration can lessen the overall amount of nutrients being carried into our streams. If you have additional questions about stormwater, you can find a full series of videos and articles by searching for Stormwater Basics on the Penn State Extension website.